is order 43, and that is personal explanation. And it reads that by the indulgence of the Senate and the leave of the President of the Senate, a senator may make personal explanation, although there be no question before the Senate, but no controversial matter may be brought before, nor may debate arise upon explanation. The terms of the proposed statement shall be submitted in details to the President of the Senate when the leave to make it is sought. Mr. President, I discussed with you before the sitting that sequence to the event that happened yesterday, where in my absence I went to pray, there was change in leadership, particularly affecting me. And I felt it is important for me to be given the chance to, as I said when I was nominated as the Senate leader, to thank my colleagues for the opportunity given to me to serve as the Senate leader. When I was nominated as the Senate leader, I said one thing that I want to repeat today, that as a senator, I'm not better than anybody here. And I also want to believe that all of us are equal in this Senate. I thank God for the way and the courage God gave me to carry on with my responsibility for the time, 1.5 years, that God said is my time as the Senate leader. So I want to thank you enormously, especially my colleagues, for the confidence you had in me. I thank God that throughout my service as the Senate leader, most of the time my colleagues casually will say, "Leader, we are proud of you." I was not found wanting for anything that I know. And because of the unity of this Senate that is more important than myself, 3 times I offered to resign, if that would bring peace. But I believe God's time is the best. You are one of those that even warned me here to stop saying that I will resign. But yesterday I was not around, change of leadership was announced. In fact, if the number of those that lost confidence in me is not up to this number, and I'm made to know, I will resign. Because I did not become a Senate leader in order to lose confidence of any of you. And that's why I'm concerned about the loss of confidence. Because as far as I know, I have not done anything. But then, just like that, the Senate caucus have the right to say, we have lost confidence in you. And I think that should be, now that I've said it, I think it's on record, that I did not do anything, not to the best of my knowledge, I did not do anything. But, as I said, since my colleagues, consciously, 30-something of them, signed, what I can see, 30-something here, is 38. Okay, don't worry. So, if they sign that they have lost confidence, what Dino is trying to bring out now, it's not what, I'm not going there at all. Because by the time you are to be removed, at least you'll be given, you'll be confronted with the allegations or what you have done, and be given chance to defend yourself. But as I said, since I have lost confidence, even if it is 10 of you members, then I have no moral ground to continue to lead this Senate, because that means there are some people that are not with me. Having said that, I want to say that this Senate is an institution that we must protect. How do you protect the institution? Is you obey the rules and the tradition. If today, just like that, without telling somebody, and he goes out, if it is Ndume today and it's okay, it may be, God forbid, Okoromadu tomorrow. Okay, so what I'm saying is, distinguished colleagues, any time our colleagues erred in one way or the other, we should be given the chance to say, look, this is what you did, and therefore we have lost confidence in you. But I